this new episode, ENT121, episode 3 of ENT121, entrepreneurship, management, ENT121. So this is episode 3 of this course, management organization. So today, we have some objectives to cover. We're going to look at concept of leadership. Who is a leader? Concept of leadership, who is a leader? We're going to look at various styles of leadership. Styles of leadership. And if time permits, we're going to take a look at communication. Look at the basic component of communication. Let's stop there. Now let's take the first outline. So at the end of today, we should be able to come to the conclusion of who a leader is, concept of leadership, various types of leadership that we have, talk about communication and the component of communication that we have. Now let's take the first one, which is leadership. What is leadership? Leadership refers to the process of influencing people to do what they actually do not want to do. That is the first definition. Now let me try to give a second definition. Leadership refers to the process by which an individual motivates people or group of people to get involved in activities they initially do not want to get involved in. That is the act of getting people do something. The act of allowing or making people to take responsibilities. That is what we call what? Leadership. That is the act. Leadership is the act of influencing people to do something. Let's stop there. So the act of influencing people to do something is what known as what? Leadership. We have and people that carried out this attribute is who we know as a leader. Who is a leader? A leader is someone who takes up the responsibility of putting people in places where they do not want to be. A leader is someone who motivates or influences people to carry out actions, to carry out activities in which they do not actually want to do. For instance, in various organizations, in our schools, in our department, we have leaders. Unfortunately, there are some people who are leaders that are not actually carrying out their task. A lot of people have been in leadership position for a lot of years, and they have never led once in their life. Why? Because they have never influenced people to do some certain things. Whereas you see a member, for instance, in your department, a member can just try to motivate you. Oh, this course, we can pass it. Oh, let's carry out tutorials. Let's do this. That person out there is a leader. That is, it doesn't mean that you don't need to attain a leadership position before you can carry out leadership responsibility. Everyone is a leader, but not everyone is an effective leader. Now let's take a look at styles of leadership, because we have established the meaning of leadership and who is a leader. Styles of leadership. Talking about styles of leadership, we have 4 to 5 styles of leadership. Permit me to list them out. The 5 styles of leadership. Styles of leadership. That is, leadership can come in various sense. Styles of leadership. Now let's take a look. We have the first one. We can have the democratic leadership. Autocratic sorry, democratic leadership, autocratic leadership, we can have the laissez-faire. Leadership, we can have the charismatic leadership, and the last one, we can have the situational leadership. Now, I'm going to explain the first one. Democratic leadership, we are talking about democratic leadership. Democratic leadership is the most effective way of leading. Is the most effective style of leadership. Why? Because it involves decision making between the leader and the members in that organization. That is, it is not only the leader that takes decision, but the leader brings this tables a particular situation and wants to hear the view of the members. Is interested in what the members has to say concerning that situation. That is, the leader tables the matter and wants to hear what their own view about the matter. Decision making is made by the leader and the members, though the leader will still take the final decision. It is the most effective way of leading. That is democratic leadership. Involves decision between the leader and the members. Now let's take a look at the next one, autocratic. We're talking about autocratic style of leadership. Autocratic style of leadership is just the style of leadership in which the leader makes the member to be conscious of his position. That is, I am the boss, I am the leader here, and the leader in this style of leadership does not want to is not concerned about the view of the members when it comes to decision making. Decision making is only made by the leader. That is, I am the boss, I will want you to do what I tell you to do. You have to do what I tell you to do. That is an autocratic style of leadership. You have a brother that says, okay, you need to do this, I don't want to hear your own. I'm dogmatic about this. When I say dogmatic, that is, I don't want to hear your own view. You have to believe what I'm telling you. This is the way. No. When you're telling me that this is the way, no. Way A is the way. You're telling me way B is the way. No, way A is the way. That is the autocratic style of leadership. You have a friend that is autocratic. Wants you to believe his own ideas all the time. That is an autocratic style of leadership. Now let's go to the next one. That is autocratic. Decision making is just by is between the is only made by the leader. Laissez-faire leadership. Laissez-faire. Let's come here. Laissez-faire. The third one. Laissez-faire. Stop. Now laissez-faire. The word laissez-faire means laissez-faire. It means let everyone do what they want. Let everyone do what they want. Now, in this type of leadership, it is a type of leadership in which the leader has a nonchalant attitude. Has a nonchalant attitude means the leader is less concerned about the activities of of the members or of that organization. It is just like a leaderless style. That is, you have a leader, but you don't even know that the leader is actually existing. You have an HOC in your department, but you don't even know if your HOC is actually existing when it comes to responsibility. You only see him once in a while. That is, he's less concerned about his responsibilities. He wants everybody to do what they want. That is a laissez-faire style of leadership, a leaderless style. You need to take note of all these points that we're listing out. So, that is leaderless style, and this laissez-faire also can refer, it also means the anarchy style. Also refers to anarchy style of leadership. Now let's go to the next one. The next one is charismatic leadership. Charismatic leadership, from the word charisma. Charismatic leadership style. Now you're talking about charismatic leadership style. A charismatic leader is one who motivates or influences his members to carry out a particular task that seems difficult. Hey guys, I know you can do this, and I know you're surely going to pass this course with distinction. Do a lot of reports by our seniors, by our predecessors. They said, oh, this course, ENT121 is very difficult. ENT121 is very difficult. Oh, this course, ECHO, this department is very difficult. But I'm telling you guys that you all are going to what? You all are going to do it. Okay, Fountain TV, you all are going to what? You're going to subscribe and like this channel. You know, that is what? Motivation. I'm trying to motivate you. And once I try to motivate you, you'll be like, wow, I can do it, I can do it. That type of leadership is what we call charismatic leadership. Okay, now our department is having football. We all are going to go there and support our what? Our department, and we're going to carry this cup. And everybody begin to shout, whoa, yes, yes, that's our leader. That is a charismatic leadership. The attribute of this leadership is worth emulating. You feel like, wow, I love that leader. I love that man. I love that brother. He has a charismatic sense of leadership. That is, he wants to what? Draw you to do, to carry out responsibilities. Now let's go to the last one, which is situational what? Style of leadership. Examples of this charismatic leadership, for instance, we can have Awolowo. About Macaulay, we can have all this Nelson Mandela. They motivate us to do more. You can have a brother that motivates you to carry out some things that you don't actually want to carry. You can have a sister, you can have a role model that motivates you to do what? To do some things. You're a lady. A lady out there motivates you to do something, then that is a charismatic sense of leadership. That's what the last one we do. Situational leadership style. Now, talking about the situational leadership style, this is a form of leadership style that tells the effectiveness and then the flexibility. Thank you. Thank you for that. The effectiveness and flexibility of a leader when it comes to approaching a particular situation. For instance, you know that this brother, your leader, your A2C is very gentle. But it comes to a matter, you see him speaking in a very furious matter. You be like, wow, is this my A2C? My A2C that is very, very quiet. Now speaking in this type of way. I have never seen my A2C rage in this form before. That is, your A2C is trying to channel a part of him that is hidden for so long. Your A2C is practicing democratic style of leadership before. But because he wants you to carry out a particular action, he brings on the autocratic form of leadership in him. Why? Because he knows that if he's taking things gently with you, this task that you want to perform will not be what? Will not be accomplished. Now, we want to what? We want to get marker, we want to get a lot of things, everybody pay money for class list. That out of 200 students, only 50 students pay. What is that? You know your agency is very gentle, but your agency stands up and looks like, hey, you all need to pay this money so that we'll be able to get this done. If you don't pay this money, your name will not be in the class list. That is an autocratic sense. Before, he was using the word democratic sense, but he changed to what? Autocratic sense. Why? That situation needs it. Situational form of what? Of leadership. I hope you get what I'm trying to say. So that is that on what? Style of leadership. But let's go to communication. I think I still have a little time. Communication. Now, let's quickly brush through communication and basic components of communication. Then in the next episode, we continue. I hope you like and subscribe. Now, communication. When we're talking about communication, communication refers to the process by which meanings are perceived and understanding reached among human beings. Communication refers to the process by which meanings are perceived and understandings reached among human beings. For you to understand me, for me to understand you, that is what communication. For me to be able to decode what you're trying to say, that is communication. Now, for communication to occur, it involves two things the what the sender of the person sending the information and the person receiving the information. That is, communication occurs between two figures. It can either be what the person sending the information, or and it will be the person sending the information and the person receiving the information, the people sending the information, the people receiving the information. Now let's take the look at the basic components of what of communication. We have 4 to 5 basic components of communication. And the basic component of communication, the basic component of communication, we have the message, which is the code. We have the encoder, which is the sender. We have the receiver, which is the decoder. And we have feedback. So, for every effective communication, you are going to have all these components present in it. So, next episode, we'll talk about all this and explain all this. Remember that in an organization, communication is very, very what? Effective. Anywhere you find yourself, we need to communicate with each other so that what understanding will be what will be cemented wherever we find ourselves. Do well to like and subscribe on this channel, Fountain TV, as we what we are tasked with giving out the best form of knowledge through the grace of God. Success. God bless you.